Very important is legato. It is the primary principle of bel canto. I mean the technical skill of the term bel canto, exactly as we can hear it so beautifully done sometimes in opera. I remember Pierre Bernac saying that those who cannot do justice to an aria by Bellini will neither be able to sing French melodie the right way. This also goes for many phrases in German Lieder. Legato must be the foundation of our singing. Occasionally, we may have to use non-legato, marcato, staccato in order to apply parlando, sprechgesang, etc. So look for possibilities to vary legato and non or less legato, not only in the melodic lines, but also in the pronunciation. Long versus short vowels. This difference is more obvious in German and Italian than in French, because the French language is, by its nature, spoken and so also sung in a more legato way. It is a misunderstanding or a bad habit to sing the syllables of words always one by one, seeing the print of one syllable to each note can be misleading. They are often supposed to form a line. Also, a legato line moves forward because you know where you want the phrase to go. There is a sense of direction. At the beginning of a phrase, you must have a clear idea of where it ends. The right legato is not only binding notes together, but also avoiding involuntary crescendo and maybe decrescendo. Singing Gregorian chant as an exercise can help to feel the binding together as well as the constant same volume. Once you have mastered this technique of legato, then you can of course bring in any variety that the music asks. Note that phrasing can be called horizontal, which would mean long and legato, or vertical, meaning rhythmical and articulate.
Thank you. sky le vende di come